Hello and welcome to DIY Tuesday here at Oil Life. We are so excited to be here and talk to you about some outdoor fun with essential oils. So we have a bug bite stick that you're going to want to try. Yes. So stick around, watch for that. We apologize for our little makeshift kitchen here. We were going to actually melt the beeswax and show you all of it, but we'll just go through the recipe real quick in our mock kitchen here. But do stay with us because we are going to be giving away 3 of these summer DIY kits. These are digital downloads, so once you download it, you'll print it out. And if you have any questions about that, please ask in the comments. We can fill you in on what's inside of here. There's about 12 to 15 recipes, depending on the season, stickers, table tents, and some gift boxes. So the 2 recipes we're going to talk about today are in here. And so make sure you're commenting to enter to win this. Our first question is, what outdoor activities do you have planned this summer?
Yeah.
Is that a good one?
Yeah.
So let us know in the comments below what outdoor activities you have planned this summer. We would love to know. Do you have any outdoor activities planned this summer?
I do. I'm hoping to go boating a little bit, you know, get out in the water, swimming, hopefully, camping.
Very nice.
Even. What about you?
Mostly hiking.
Fun.
I'm a hiker. So wish I could go camping, though.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So all those activities. And so what comes with all those activities?
Bugs.
Bugs.
Pests.
So we have some bug recipes for you. We are going to start with the first one, which is our bug bite stick. So it's after you get the bug bite, and it's itchy and scratchy, and that's not a word, but you want to scratch it because it's itchy. And so the bug bite helps relieve that. It helps relieve the inflammation, the pain, and the itchy feeling.
Yep.
So Sarah's going to take us through that.
Rub it right on your bug bite. So. A couple things that we're going to use for this. We have our ingredients are going to be coconut oil, beeswax. We've got a couple different oils here. And then make sure that you have a place to put your bug bite stick. So we actually chose to use this fun little mold with bugs in it. Super cute. But you can also use
lip balm tubes.
Lip balm tube, or we also have these little guys too.
The poly jars. I don't know the full name, but it starts with poly if you want to look it up at the website.
Yes. So first things first, we are going to get a pan, and you are going to put, it will be 2 tablespoons of our beeswax. So you can actually get that here at Oil Life. Super convenient. You're going to put that in with 3 tablespoons of coconut oil. Okay. So you'll mix it in there. You'll stir it until it's completely liquid.
It takes about 8 minutes to get to that point.
Yes, it does.
8 minutes on the stove.
So on the stove, and then you'll pull it off the stove, and you'll wait for it to cool down to a more lukewarm temperature. So don't let it totally set up, but make sure it's less hot. So that's when you'll stir in your oils. So we have a couple different oils in this recipe. We've got a cleansing blend, we've got lavender, melaleuca, and we've got frankincense. So you will put 20 drops of our cleansing blend in here. So you'll put 20 drops in once it's cooled down to a more lukewarm temperature. You'll put 20 drops of lavender, 20 drops of melaleuca, and then you'll only put 10 drops of frankincense in there. So you'll mix that all together. It's still going to be a little bit liquidy, and then it's probably going to start to set up. So that's when you have to pour it into your mold. So whichever you chose, as we said, we chose these fun little bug bite molds, and you're going to pour it in there, and you're going to let them set up overnight. So give it about 24 hours, and they should be cooled down and hardened and ready to go.
Yeah, and look perfect like this. These are ours, and so she warned me about that before I did this. But they look just like little bugs. This is a butterfly, which wouldn't bite you, but
super cute.
That one would. Cool. This one would bite you.
Fly maybe.
So they smell really good.
They smell awesome.
But I just want to mention a few things. So when we made this, since the recipe only calls for 3 tablespoons of coconut oil and 3 tablespoons of beeswax, we went ahead and times it by 8 to make all of these, and we had quite a bit extra. And so that's just something to think about. It took us 8 minutes to melt our concoction, but it wasn't 8 times the recipe. If you just 1 times it, so if you just use the recipe exactly how it is in the DIY download, it'll make approximately 4 of these tubes, 6 of these tubes, and 1 of these bugs. So think about that as you're doing the recipe and what that kind of turns out to be. And then we also gave one of these to our general manager
recently
because she had some mosquito bites that were bugging her.
Some bad ones.
Yeah, irritating her. So what did she say about it?
She actually came up to us today and she was like, you guys, it was amazing. It actually worked. Like, I didn't even notice them. Like, they helped. So we do have a witness. Like, these work. I would definitely recommend making them. They're awesome.
Yeah. So, let us know in the comments below what you guys do for bug bites. What is your typical go-to? Do you use a off-the-counter, off-the-shelf remedy? Do you use essential oils? If you do use essential oils, what are your favorites? Like we said, this recipe uses the cleansing blend, lavender, melaleuca, and frank. So if not these ones, which ones have you used in the past and which ones work for you? So now we're going to talk about a recipe that is before the bugs bite you.
Yes.
Which probably we should have done first.
We should have, but
that's okay. Because, you know, you want to protect yourself. I mean, this is great that you can relieve the itch after, but we want to make it so that we don't get those bug bites to begin with.
Awesome bug spray.
So I'm just going to show you real quick. So these are the two recipes for the bug bite stick and the bug repellent that come in the DIY kit. So these are the table tints. So they're really fun, have that marble effect to them that we love with our stickers this summer. So I'm going to go over the recipe for the bug repellent real quick. So she's showing you the sticker from the lookbook. You can also print that off in your DIY download. And it fits in this 4-ounce bottle. I think that's our ombre one too, which we love.
Yes, it is. If you can see it, super, super cute.
It's a 4-ounce glass spray bottle. You use witch hazel, which again, we do sell this at Oil Life. You can come into the store or buy it online. So witch hazel, which is great for the skin, soothing, and then peppermint, eucalyptus, melaleuca, and cedarwood. I love that mix. I love all those oils right
there.
That's great. That's a great recipe. So that is repellent, and so you would make sure you shake it before each use and then spray it on before you go out into a bug infested or possibly bug infested area.
Yes.
Because sometimes you don't know they're there. So whenever you're going outdoors, that would be a great thing. Going out to the wilderness.
Too, so.
I didn't get to smell it. Can I smell it?
Smells awesome. Yeah. I'm a fan.
Did you smell it?
Yes. Earlier.
Are you sure you don't want to smell it live on video? Okay, so make sure you're commenting. Let us know your favorite. So we asked you what your outdoor adventures were planned this summer, but now I want to know your favorite outdoor location. So it might be not on your summer list this season, but maybe it's just a place that you really love to go, out in the woods or to a park. What's your favorite one that you like to go to? And that's a wrap. So if you have any questions about either of these recipes, also feel free to ask those questions in the video below. If you have any questions about the summer DIY kit, again, make sure you ask those questions. Make sure you're sharing and commenting about these recipes or about your experiences with bugs and outdoors so that you can potentially win one of these. Again, we're giving away three. Keep that in mind. And then I just wanted a couple announcements at the end. So this again is our lookbook. Get these stickers. Every order comes with one. There's also a $5 off, $50 purchase coupon code on the back. Another reason to get yourself some of these, either come into the store, get one, or order, and then you can get $5 off your next order. And then I also wanted to talk about, again, I'm always plugging this, we do take your social posts and highlight them in our lookbook, in some of our other social and marketing media, so make sure you're using the hashtags, hashtag Oil Life, if the Essential Life book is in it, hashtag The Essential Life. And then this summer we're using two special hashtags, hashtag Summer of Sharing and hashtag Summer of Success. Those specifically we're looking at for our autumn lookbook because that's the theme of our autumn lookbook. So make sure that you are showing us how you're being successful with your oil business and how you're sharing your oil lifestyle. We want to see those. We want to highlight them. And then lastly, our monthly event is next week, next Thursday, July 27th. It'll be from 7 to 8 p.m. live here on our Facebook page. So make sure you let your friends know about that. There is a page to RSVP so that it'll remind you, but just so everyone knows, we will be going live on the actual Oil Life page, so there's no confusion. So make sure you share that with everyone you know that's going, and it'll also notify you as well. So thank you for joining us. Again, make sure to get those comments in and make sure that you're being entered to win one of those DIY kits.